wonderful seeing everybody this morning. We're going to go ahead and get started with our prayer. Amen. And with our scriptures. Hallelujah. If there are any prayer requests you want to verbalize them, please stand and do so. If you just want us to remember you or remember the issue, just raise your hand. Amen. Amen. And we will do so. Amen. 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 Continue to remember my sister.
Yes.
She had a fall last week, and so all of last, I forgot what day she was at the hospital, and so we've been meetings every week trying to deal with the situation. So I ask that you guys will pray along with me and my family.
Yes.
Amen. That God will work his perfect work in her, because he still has a plan for her. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Just as he has a plan for you, for your loved ones. Amen. I want you to understand, as we get ready to go before prayer, that anything is possible in God.
Yes.
You just have to believe it.
Yes.
We have to grab a hold to our faith.
Yes.
So when we go before the Lord in prayer,
yes,
believe God.
Yes.
Believe God. Whether you're in corporate, yes, prayer at the church or you're at home,
yes,
believe God,
yes,
for the things that you ask for. Believe him. And if you're praying wrong, trust me, God's going to help you. Because you can ask him to teach me how to pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's stand. Let's stand. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We used to prepare our hearts as we go before the Lord by just saying, I need thee, oh, I need thee. Lord God, hallelujah, God, that you would favor us on today, God. With trust your word, God. We trust you to do it, oh God. We trust you to heal the house, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God. We trust you to bind up every spirit of confusion. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. We trust you, oh God, to bind up the spirit of backbiting. In the name of Jesus, oh God. We trust you to cast down every 100, and then I'm going to just do the first two verses of 101. And it reads on this wise. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Now make it personal and say, I will sing of mercy and judgment unto thee. O Lord, will I sing. I will behave myself wisely in a perfect way.
All right.
O, when thou come unto me, I will walk within my house with a perfect heart. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his holy word in the name of Jesus. Now at this time, we're going to receive our praise and worship leaders. Hallelujah, as they come. Minister Javier and Sister Elizabeth, let's pray for them, oh God, and join in with the worship as Jesus leads them. God bless you.
And sings my soul.
study, hallelujah, in the middle of praising the Lord with the practice, the song ain't even done yet, and we were worshiping the Lord. Because it's an attitude thing, hallelujah. This isn't a game. This is, we are worshiping the Almighty this morning, hallelujah. I have asked my wife to sing a song this morning. She's come revived with a 3-4 day revival with women up in a camp somewhere. I'll do that every week. Listen too much. Sister Elizabeth Vasquez with us, hallelujah.
Opportunity to be here again. We love the Lord and we worship him. Amen. Because he is worthy. We give glory and honor to him. Today is a bittersweet day for me. I am celebrating my dad's 5th year in heaven. This exact day. And it's a victory. It's bittersweet because I'm sad because I miss him, but it's a victory because he longed to walk those streets of gold. His life journey was to make it, and he fought the good fight, and he is rejoicing, and he can't wait for us to get there to rejoice with him. And this was one of his songs that he loved to sing, and I'm going to try to sing it without breaking down, but pray for me. He just loved the Lord so much, and in remembrance of him today, I give God the glory and the honor.
Thank you.
know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Come on. I don't know what you came to do.
Because I don't know if y'all if you guys are picking up on something. But if you were in Sunday school this morning, and if you were here from the beginning of service and even through now,
come on.
The Spirit of the Lord is setting the theme for the day.
Yeah.
And it's personal.
Mm.
It's personal.
Yeah.
It's about my relationship with God.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's about our relationship with God. But today he's making it personal. I was thinking, they were singing that song, "Since I Laid My Burdens Down." I just had to kind of turn and hold myself because I felt myself going in that way. Hallelujah. Because it's one that, it's one part that said, when friends don't treat me like they used to. Stuff all over my face. I'm like, y'all had me walking around here looking like this? And I'm sitting of our personal relationship and responsibility to God. Come on, Sister Roz. Hallelujah. And y'all, I don't be planning to get up here and say that. I promise you that. I promise you. I just be trying to keep the flow going. Hallelujah. But I get up here and the Lord gets to talking. Hallelujah. And I got to go. You know, it's like he's standing in the back of me, pushing me like this here. You want to remember to keep them lifted up in prayer. All right? I'm serious. You want to keep them lifted up in prayer. Because that's where the adversary is going to come to the attack. If he's going to do anything at Cedar Grove, he's going to come for the head. Because if you get the head, then everything else is going to fall. You know? And even though I was watching something the other day, and the thing was dead, but the body was still moving. But it was just uncontrolled actions. It had no order to it. It had no, you know, so, you know, you have to be careful. And it's important that we as the body of believers, that we keep our leadership in prayer. Amen. Keep his family in prayer. Amen. Because that's the way that the enemy comes. You know, I was reading something that earlier this year, maybe last year, where they were, it was this big old uproar about the look on one of the president's daughter's faces while he was making a speech. And they made this big thing and judged this whole woman and put this attack on this little teenage girl by a little quick 10-second glimpse of what her facial expression was. She's a teenager. What do you think she wanted to be? Hallelujah. But she couldn't help what her daddy does. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, God has called him to the ministry. God has called him to this place for this hour and for this day. His kids still have the life, their life, the wife. She still has her life and she supports her husband and everything. But you stop looking at them or expecting them to be him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We got to pray that the Lord would gird them up and lift them up and keep them. Hallelujah. Now that's if you want them to keep them. Hallelujah. Now if you don't want them to keep them, that's something different. But if you're concerned about your leadership, if you're concerned about Cedar Grove, if you're concerned about this body, you're going to pray for your leadership. They need our prayers. They really do. Hallelujah. Because it's no easy task standing up here doing anything. Anything. Amen. Amen. Least of all. You know, we know that, you know, sometimes when you put on certain hats, everybody's watching you. Hallelujah. Everybody. And they just waiting for you. We talked about this Sunday school this morning. They just waiting to find something out of place with you. You know, if you're the leader or the supervisor on your job or something like that, trust me, somebody, they looking at you all the time. They just waiting. If you're the new person on the job, they looking at you and they waiting. You know, just to find something. You see what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we want to keep them lifted up. And as we keep them lifted up, guess what he's doing? He's interceding for us. He's interceding. He's not a novice. He spends time in study. He spends time in the presence of God so that he can stand before the people of God. Hallelujah. Not just in the pulpit, but outside the pulpit. As he represents Cedar Grove here, there, and everywhere. So we just want to, that was just a little insert. Again, I tell y'all, I don't be planning this stuff. I don't sit down there and say, you know, I'm going to say this and I'm going to say that. I get up here and I have to speak what the Lord directs me to speak. Hallelujah, glory to God. And I feel the presence of the Lord calling out for order in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. And we can do it, Cedar Grove. Amen. Do you believe we can do it? Hallelujah. Do you believe that we have the power to stand against the wiles of the devil? Do you believe in what the word of God says when it says, put on the whole armor of God? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Then we must put on the whole armor of God. Hallelujah. And we got to pray. Pray one for another. We talked about that Sunday school lesson was so good this morning, and not because I had to teach it, but I was rushing here this morning hoping that I could teach it, because as I studied it, it was just so good. It was so good, because it was talking about the post-exilic state of Jerusalem. And that just means that when they came back after exile, and they were coming back and trying to restore order and build back up the house of God and build back up the place of God. But what happened was they got this mentality in them because of all of what they had to go through to get back to this place, that they had a problem with somebody else coming in here, now reaping the benefits and of their hard work, of the sweat that was off their brow. But the thing about it is, it's God's house for a reason. At your house, you got your name on the deed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Here, God has his name on the deed. I'm not talking about the building, but I'm talking about the house of God. And God said that Judah are to come in here and provide for the house of God, that there might be meat in my house. Hallelujah. Why? Because somebody is going to walk in the door hungry. Somebody is going to walk in the door thirsty. Somebody is going to walk in the door and they're going to have a need. And if the house of God is not standing in the place of God the way that God ordained it, somebody is going to come in here and walk back out wounded and broken, and the blood of that person is going to be on your head. We have a responsibility.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The lesson was talking about judging justly. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And God has an expectation of us because he's a holy and a just God.
Yeah.
That we should do that which is right in the sight of God. And as we pointed out this morning, and I gave a real way, way out scenario, had everybody heated, hallelujah, about how they was going to handle it.
Yeah.
And it was one of them kind of situations that the flesh would rise up way before the spirit was even thought about.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But one thing, sometimes, and not sometimes, but in all things,
yeah,
let God arise.
Yeah.
And let our enemies be scattered.
All right, all right.
We got to let God arise.
Yeah.
In us.
Yes.
And sometimes it has to be the Jesus in me.
Yes.
That sees the Jesus in you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And I can't judge you by the act, by one act, or one situation that took place.
Yes.
I've got to see the Jesus in you.
Oh, yes.
And if I can see the Jesus in you, then I can believe, God, that the Jesus in you can fix the hurt that's in you, that can fix the problem that's in you, that can fix the confusion that's in you, that can fix the misunderstanding that's between us. Hallelujah. But I've got to be able to see,
yes,
the Jesus in you. And the only way that I'm able to do that is got to have Jesus in me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And it's so easy.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's call for the officers as we receive, hallelujah, our offering for today. Amen, amen. This is a time where we can all play a part. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As I was just talking, alluding to a few minutes ago, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. Hallelujah. And y'all, let me tell you about it. It ain't about your money, because God do not need your money. Trust me when I tell you. He can work a miracle without your money and leave you penniless because you held on to your money. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He tells us that because he wants to see our obedience to his word. Not to me, because I gave you word. I didn't put that in there. Because if it was left up to me, I don't know. I might tell you, look, y'all keep your money. Everybody bring $5 a week. You know? But I'm not the one who blessed you. It was God. And if you believe him and if you believe his word, do what thus saith the Lord. In the hands of the sister Alicia, come forth. Come forth. Amen. We praise God for her ministry. Hallelujah. And it's definitely blossoming and doing wonderful, wonderful things. Hallelujah. Y'all just seeing her at Cedar Grove, but I remember back in the Bethlehem Temple days when she was getting going. Hallelujah. And I can tell you, God has done great things, whereof we are glad. Let's receive Sister Alicia now in Jesus' name. Rest on your feet. you rest on your feet. Amen. As you rest on your feet. Mr. Axton.
Hi.
And I want to present this sermon and introduce to you others. The angel of this house, Pastor Cedar Grove, been praying for Elder Ray Boykins. And we're asking all, don't just look at him and don't sit on him. Pray with him. Pray for him. Support him. Hallelujah. As he brings forth the word, glory to God. Hear your amens. Let him hear. Hallelujah. Most important, that let God know you got it. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So let's, as always, let's point our hands towards our pastor. Say, preach, pastor.
Preach, pastor.
Preach, pastor. In Jesus' name, preach.
Come on, let's put our hands together for Jesus. Come on, let's put our hands together for the Lord. If God done anything for you, you ought to praise the Lord. You ought to give him glory. You ought to praise the Lord for his goodness sake. Did he wake you up this morning? Did he start you on your way? Well, you ought to be glad about it. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful this morning. I'm grateful that God woke me up. I'm glad that God started me on my way. I'm glad that God placed me in my right mind. Anybody in your right mind this morning? Well, you got something to be glad about. Anybody not got tubes hooked up to their body? Well, you got something to be grateful for. Anybody not trying to grab a breath? You got something to be grateful for. Hallelujah. Somebody would love to be in your shoes. Oh, you're not going to talk back to me. That's all right. I'll praise the Lord, but I'm by myself. There's somebody on Skid Row. Wish they were in Cedar Grove. There's somebody at the hospital. Wish they were in Cedar Grove. I think while I got a chance, I'm going to praise the Lord. I don't care who praises the Lord with me. I praise him all by my, all by myself. Why? Because he's been good. Good. Somebody say good. Somebody say good. Somebody say good. God's been good. You may be seated. Glory to God. I can get excited real quick. See, it don't take me very much. See, because I came from a mighty,
hallelujah,
a mighty long way. And see, I'm not scared to talk about it. I'll let you know where I came from. Glory to God. He took me out of the miry clay and placed my feet, glory to God, on sturdy ground. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Y'all fell right from heaven. But I'm here today to tell you, God had to renew my strength. He had to pick me up, turn me around, wash me with his blood. Hallelujah. You know how some pastors later they talk, oh, I ain't never did nothing. That ain't my testimony. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But God took me from the world. Glory to God. Snatched me out of the devil's hand. Hallelujah. Changed my life. You don't understand why I get excited. It's because God saved my life. See, I came from the dead. Should have died of a heart attack. Should have lost my mind. Glory to God. Should have been on Skid Row. But guess what? He placed my feet. Solid ground. Not because I'm the pastor of Cedar Grove, but all because I got everlasting life. got a life beyond this life that is guaranteed. She's recovering, glory to God, from her surgery. And as he said, that therapy ain't nothing nice. Glory to God, I've been there. Glory to God, ain't nothing nice. And we just thank God for what he's doing in Cedar Grove. Thank God for what he's doing in Cedar Grove. Glory to God, Sister Jerry went into surgery and came out and back at the church. It's one thing to go in, but it's a whole other thing. Y'all ain't gonna talk back to me. He's gonna let me do this by myself. I wish I had some help in here. Glory to God. Huh? Hallelujah. I wish I had some help. Praising the Lord. It's good when we all praise the Lord together. It's good when we all come together. Glory to God. Everybody's open their mouth and they're praising him. But because when praise is coming up. Glory to God. So I thank God. Thank God. We thank God for everybody that's doing something in Cedar Grove. Everybody's doing something. I hope nobody's not doing nothing. Hope nobody's not doing nothing. If you are, you need to find yourself doing something for the Lord. We should be only sitting for so long.
Right.
Hallelujah. Before we're busy for the Lord. Because only what you do for Christ.
There you go. Hallelujah.
Only what you do for Christ will last. Glory to God. Give honor to my wife and the family.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank God for my daughter. She's getting ready to go back to New York this week. Yeah. Summertime is over.
Wait. Amen. You didn't get one dance?
I know.
We didn't get one dance?
Pray for her. But I know. I don't think I wasn't. Glory to God. Blessed Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Maybe next time she's going to come back with one. Maybe next time she's going to come back with one. The Bible says train up a child in the way they should go. And when they are old, they will not depart from it. Glory to God. I thank God that they were raised up like I was raised up. So look at the finished product here.
Yes.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is a miracle working God. God, don't you ever say somebody's beyond repair. I don't care how bad it looks. Glory to God. You really don't know my story. Hallelujah. God can do anything. Glory to God. Thank you, sister. Hallelujah. We thank God for Sister Shannon and putting together our bulletins and working in the background. Glory to God. Hard worker. Some don't know she travels from Lancaster. And we thank God for her. We thank God for everybody that's doing something. Those who are working in the kitchen. Glory to God. To those who are doing repairs. We need that. We need that. And we thank God for those that come and clean. Thank God for Sister Bryant, glory to God, hard working, and she's faithful.
Amen.
Faithful. She's out at every meeting. I don't care. And then the first one to show up, now it used to be Sister Wilson, but now Sister Bryant didn't step right. y'all quiet, that's all right. I'm going to give praise when I will do. Hallelujah. I wish some people would be here. Amen, amen. Glory to God. Thank God for my help, Elder Davis. Amen, glory to God. Glory to God, teaching the word on Sunday morning. Glory to God, what a powerful Sunday school that we had. I don't know about you. I just can't get enough word. Some people say, oh, I just come on Sunday. I don't know. Sunday ain't enough for me. I need it on Monday. I need it on Tuesday. I need it on Wednesday. And I can't wait for Thursday. Thursday night, we had a good time, y'all. Y'all missed it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, glory to God. We were talking about the afterlife. What happens when you close your eyes or when you take your last breath? What happens then? Glory to God. We found out that there was a rich man that opened up his eyes in hell. Glory to God. You know, everybody preaches, you know, everybody's going to heaven. Well, there's some people, some people are going the other way. I'm sorry to report. Hallelujah. If the rich man opened his eyes up in hell, somebody's not going to heaven. But I hope all of Cedar Grove. Oh, glory to God. We all going to heaven. Come on, somebody say heaven. So come on, glory to God. We were studying the 15th chapter of the First Corinthians. Glory to God. We didn't make it halfway through it. Glory to God. And there was questions, and we was going back and forth, and it was just exciting what God was doing in the Bible class. So we need you to come out and participate. We're having a great time. We thank God, hallelujah, for Minister Javier. Glory to God. We had an awesome time at a rehearsal. Awesome. Glory to God. Hallelujah. How God just came in into the song. Like I said, we had worship service in the rehearsal. I felt like shouting in the rehearsal. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So come out every other Thursday. We have it at 7 o'clock. Glory to God. Not this Thursday for the rehearsal, but the following. Glory to God. Come on out. Glory to God. And I'm glad to see our guests right here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come back again. Hallelujah. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. They were here on Friends and Family Day. And glory to God. And they knew some people that used to go here. I forget the name now. But they knew some past people here. And they just felt led to come again today. And I just thank God for you guys coming. Hallelujah. Feel at home. Feel at home. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It takes all of us. Anybody like that word together?
Yes.
Besides me? Huh? Come on, give God a hand, praise if you like together. Glory to God. Together! Together. All right, that's my commercial. All right, if you would turn to the book of Psalms.
All right.
42nd chapter. The first verse. If you would stand for the reading. Glory to God. I'm going to ask Minister Davis if he was so kind in that biblical voice. Read the word.
Psalm 47, verse 1.
Oh, 47. Right. Yes. All right. See, when he said it, I had it right in my head, but I turned to the wrong page.
As the heart panteth after the water brooks, so panteth my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night. While they continually say unto me, where is thy God? When I remembered these things, I poured out my soul in me. For I had gone with the multitude. I went with them to the house of God with the voice of joy and praise, with the multitude that kept holy day. Why art thou cast? And why art thou disquieted in me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him for the help of his countenance. O my God, my soul is cast down within me. Therefore will I remember these from the land of Jordan and of the of Hebron, oh no, the Harmonites of the hill Mizar.
Drop down to verse 11. No, verse 9.
I said unto God, my rock.
Yes.
Why hast thou forgotten me?
My rock.
Why go I mourning because of the oppression of the enemy?
Uh-huh.
As with a sword in my bones, my enemies reproach me.
Right.
While they say daily unto me, where is thy God? Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him, who is in the health of my countenance and my God.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come before you so graciously, Lord, asking you to touch this word right now, Lord. Let it go to the hearts, the mind, the souls of your people, Lord. Open up their mind, their heart, and their soul right now, Jesus, that they might receive your word, Lord. Lord Jesus, prepare this food, Lord Jesus. Let it be nourishment to their soul, Lord. Lord Jesus, let them lift them up, Lord, to another height, Lord. Hallelujah. Take them from the low into the high, Lord. Take them from the down, Lord, into your glory, Lord. Lord Jesus, and we'll give you the praise, we'll give you the honor in Jesus' name. I now decrease.
Yes,
that you might increase in me, Lord. Lord Jesus, right now we thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And if I had a topic today, glory to God, it would be hope in God.
Yes, yes. All right, sir.
Hope in God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Won't you look over to your neighbor and tell them to hope in God. Come on, tell them again. They didn't receive that one. Glory to God. Tell them to hope in God. Hallelujah. You know what? Change is something else. And sometimes change can throw you for a loop. Somebody said, when you least expect it, expect it.
Right, right, right.
But I don't know about you. It would be kind of nice, though, when change would come, that it would send me an email or something, glory to God, that it's about to happen.
Right.
It would be nice if it could send me a letter. Glory to God in the mail that something is about to occur. It would be nice if a telegram could come, glory to God, saying that change is on the way. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But we know, glory to God, that's not going to happen. Hallelujah. And it would be nice if change would not only send me a notification that it's about to happen, but that it would give me a map, glory to God, that I might be able to get out of the change that's about to occur. Come on, somebody say amen. Glory to God. Most of the times these things are not going to happen. So my hope has to be in God. My trust has to be in God that no matter what occurs, glory to God, I got God on my side. It doesn't matter what the situation is. Doesn't matter how cold it might get. God, doesn't matter how rainy or stormy it might seem, my hope says, glory to God, you gonna make it. My hope says, I can do it. My hope says, I can do all things. that strengthens me. You see, my hope is not in what people say. It's not in what people do. It's not on my job. My hope is not in my job. My hope is not in my bank account. It's not in that check that's supposed to come, glory to God. It's not in what the doctor says, glory to God. It's not in my friends. It's not in my family. But I place not all my hope. All my hope is in God. I put all my chips on God. I put everything on God. I'm looking for God to work out every problem. I'm looking for God to fix every change. I'm looking for God to turn it around. Anybody else looking for God today? Is there anybody else looking for God today? Yeah. Oftentimes we believe that God has moved from us and he doesn't hear us, and we are not feeling like God hears our prayers. But I believe that God answers in three different ways. One is yes. And you know what? Everybody wants to hear a yes. Glory to God. But how many know that yes might not be the right thing for me? Glory to God. See, I believe God knows exactly what we need and when we need it. So yes might not be the right answer. Hallelujah. He also says no. Nobody wants to hear no. Hallelujah. You don't want to hear from your mother. You don't want to hear from the bank. You don't want to hear it on the job. You don't want no kind of way. Glory to God. But no might be the best. No might be the best thing for me. See, God knows what's best for me. I'm leaning on him and not to my own understanding. He said, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct my path. But most of the time, it's not right now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It might not be for me right now. Just like the prodigal son. He wanted all his money now. He wanted all his substance now. Glory to God. But when he got it, he found himself in a pig pen and said, how did I get here? Glory to God. Hallelujah. How did I get into this mess? Because you got the blessing too early. Glory to God. Sometimes we have to wait on the Lord. Hallelujah. Wait on the Lord. And be of good courage. And he shall renew your strength. I'm looking for God to renew my strength. So while I wait for the Lord, I think I give God some praise. While I'm waiting on the Lord, I think I'll be encouraged. I think I'll raise my hand. I think I'll stop my foot until the Lord comes. Hallelujah. See, you already been through the worst times. You already been through the bad times. But see, I believe that the best is yet to come. I believe that the best is on its way. I believe that the best is about to show up. All you gotta do is just hold on. Somebody say, hold on. Hold on just a little while longer. It will pay off after a while. Here today to tell you that the devil has emptied his clip on the church, but the church still stands. Some of us has took his best shot, but guess what? You're still here. The devil thought he was going to get rid of you, but you're still here. He thought he was going to discourage you, but you're still here. He thought you was going to quit and throw in the towel, but guess what? You're still here. Why? Because of the power of the Lord. Longest is on my side. I know I'll be all right. Been through rough times and barely made it. Been through the storm and rain, but you made it. He's trying to blow out the church fire, but I believe that he's only going to blow up the fire. I think he's only going to make the fire bigger. Every time the devil tries something, glory to God, God knows just what to do. God knows just what to do. I don't have to fight. He'll fight your battles. You don't have to get mad. He'll fight your battles. You don't have to run. He'll fight. See, spiritual hope has to kick in when natural hope kicks out. And God never meant for us to live our lives in the valley, glory to God. And sometimes we walk around with smiles on our faces, but on the inside, glory to God, people don't know the storm that's raging. You're looking good on the inside. Outside, I mean, you're looking good. Hallelujah. But they don't know the Hurricane Katrina that's going on the inside. They don't know the struggle that it took for you to get to church this morning. They don't know what it took for you to roll out of bed. They don't know what it took for you just to have a smile on your face. They don't know what it took for you to get down to Cedar Grove. But I thank God you found a way. I thank God that he made a way out of no way. I thank God. Hope, hope, hope in God. Don't lose your hope. Lose your friends. Don't lose your hope. Lose your family. Don't lose your hope. Lose your companion. Don't lose your hope. Lose your job. Oh, glory to God. My hope is on Christ. I'm trying to preach this thing. Y'all ain't gonna help me. They say in between Malachi of the Old Testament and Matthew of the New Testament, there was about 400 years of silence. And you know us. Anything we hate more is silence. Glory to God. There was no prophecies being said. There was no new word. Hallelujah. There was no prophet standing forth. Nothing but silence. It was quiet, glory to God. Why? Because there was about to be a shift. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying this morning. There was about to be a shift in what was about to happen. Yeah, it was quiet. Yeah, it was silent. Then came Jesus. Oh, glory to God. It was quiet for 400 years. Then all of a sudden, Jesus came on the scene and he changed everything. He turned the world around. What a shift. I don't know about you, but I feel a shift happening. I don't know about you. I feel a change getting ready to occur. church, there's about to be a shift. A shift in your happiness. A shift in your gladness. A shift in your prayer life. A shift in your family life. A shift on the job. A shift in your home. When Jesus shows up, it changes everything. But see, we're so afraid of change. I don't want to change. I don't want to do something different. But if God be for me, I said, if God be for me, he's more than the world against me. If God be for me, he's more than any imp, any devil. He's more. from making the next move in God, you ought to kick that enemy out of your way and give God the glory. For God I live, and for God I'll die. Glory to God. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about determination that passes all understanding. They say, why are you so deep into it? Glory to God, I owe him all. I don't know about you and what you owe, but I own everything. I own my life. I own my liberty. I own my peace. I own my joy. I own everything. There's nothing, Sister Elizabeth. Thank God for Sister Elizabeth. There's nothing that I won't do for Jesus. I will stand alone.
All right, sir.
Flat-footed, assured, confident in God. Your hope on houses, don't build it on land, don't build it on people, don't build it on stuff. Build your hope on God. Hallelujah. It will pay off. Hold on just a little while longer. It will pay off. Look at Cedar Grove. Glory to God. Used to just be me and a few people right here. But since we've been together, I keep pumping that together. I can't do this by myself. I need you. You need me to survive. Huh? Sister Elizabeth, I can't do it without you. Minister Javier, I can't do it without you. Elder Davis, I can't do it without you. Brother Rondi, I can't do it without you. Sister Rhys, I can't do it without you. Sister Jerry, I can't do it without you. Sister Brian, I can't do it without you. Sister Lucia, I don't know how to do all the hands like that. Glory to God, to put those words together and sign. I can't. I don't have that gift. Glory to God. Sister Angela, glory to God. I can't do what you do. Glory to God. You know, sometimes it's just a person coming up in the church with a smile.
Yeah.
And change somebody's world around. Sometimes it's not a word, but it's a hug. People are looking to be loved. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. I'm not talking about the world's love, but I'm talking about, come on, man, God's love. I need you. You need me. We need each other. I can't play this organ like you, Minister Javier. I need you here. God ordained this. I couldn't have wrote this with a book.
Yes, I hear you.
This one right here, I couldn't have wrote this with a book.
Yes,
but look what God is doing. We have to stay on the right path. Stay on the same path. Let's not get to a place where we're not grateful for what God has done. Or get big-headed because we see a few folks in the house. I can't afford to do that. This house ought to be full just by this block alone. We need more people from the neighborhood in here. Hallelujah. This house ought to be full just with this neighborhood alone. Glory to God. All right, is there one?
Yeah.
Is there one? Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's tired, glory to God, of the way that they've been going, of the direction that you've been traveling. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And you want to make a change. Glory to God. I love that song by the Hawkins. A change, a change. A wonderful change has come over me. Glory to God. I am not the same, but I've been changed by the blood of the Lamb. Washed and renewed because of Christ's blood that he shed on Calvary's cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Won't you come? Won't you come? His arms are wide open. His arms are wide open to you. And he's calling your name. He said, I'll knock at the door. And if any man answer, I'll come in. God is not going to force us to do anything. He's not going to force us to change. You have to want it on your own. You have to say, Lord, here I am. I surrender all. All to thee, my perfect Savior. I want to give my life to you. Hallelujah. And we all know what's right and what's wrong in our lives. And we all have a higher mountain to climb. Glory to God. This is your opportunity. Bring it to Christ. Lay it down at his feet. Glory to God. Give it to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And say, well, what must I do? In the book of Acts 2 and 38, they asked Peter and said, what must I do? He said, repent. Glory to God. Everyone, repent. What does repent mean? It means to change. Change your mind, change your direction. And he said, be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. So removal of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. I don't know about you, but I would get the Holy Ghost if I didn't have it. It's the best gift in the world. There's no other greater on this earth, on this side of heaven, than the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. This is your opportunity. This is your time. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Won't you come? Won't you come? Hallelujah. Come to Jesus. Leave it here. hallelujah, at the altar. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Here I am. Cedar Grove.